Hello everyone. In the last video, we have seen functionals dependent on higher order derivatives. Okay, so till now we have seen the functionals which are of the type where capital F is depending on x, y, y dash. Then capital F is depending on x, y1, y2 till yn, y1 dash, y2 dash till yn dash. Yes, that means functionals depending on more than one function. And we have also seen the functionals of the type where capital F is depending on x, y, y dash, y double dash, y triple dash, and so on, the nth derivative. Okay. So these are the different types of functionals that we have seen. In this second case, in particular, we have seen the functionals where f is depending on x, y of x, and z of x. Okay, so there n is equal to 2. And then for the third case, in particular, we have seen the functionals where capital F is depending on x, y, y dash, and y double dash. Okay, but we have derived the Euler-Poisson equation, which in general allows you to find the extremum of a given functional if the capital F is having the nth derivative of the function y of x. Okay, so we have seen only till second derivative. You can very well apply the Euler-Poisson equation and solve the problem if you are given the functional where it is depending on y, triple dash, and so on. Okay, and a same case with this as well. So today we will look at one more different type of functional, that is functionals dependent on functions of several independent variables. Okay, or in all these, one thing was common, that is this function y of x, whatever we were dealing with, was depending only on one independent variable, that is x. Okay, so therefore whenever we used to write this inside the integral sign, integration was with respect to x. Okay, so even in this case we were dealing with several functions. That means function y1, y2, y3, yn. But all of them were depending on the single independent variable, that is x. Okay. So these were of the form y1 of x, y2 of x. Okay. And therefore, when we write this inside the integral sign, it was written as this into dx. Okay. Again, for the third type as well, when we were dealing with these functionals, this capital F was depending on function y of x, where y is a function of only one independent variable, that is x. Okay, so this was of the form y of x, y dash of x, y double dash of x. Okay, and when we write this term inside the integral sign, the integration was done with respect to x. But today we will look at slightly different kind, that is functionals dependent on functions of several independent variables. So this title itself tells you that here in place of y, we will be having some function, let's call it as some function z, which will depend on some more variables and not only on the x. Okay, so it will depend on x1, x2, and xn, several independent variables. Okay, to start with, what we will do is we will restrict to only two variables. Okay, and once we get comfortable with this, meaning we derive the conditions to find extremum of such a functional, then we will generalize the concept for the n for a function which is depending on n variables. Okay, but to start with, we will stick only to two variables. Like for example, here when we solved problems, we have solved it for y of x and z of x. That means n was equal to 2. This capital F was depending on two functions. ओके, बट इन जनरल इट कैन डिपेंड ऑन एन डिफरेंट फंक्शंस. ओके, इन अ सिमिलर वे व्हाट वी विल डू इज फर्स्ट वी विल लुक एट फंक्शनल्स विच आर हैविंग अ फंक्शनल्स डिपेंडेंट ऑन फंक्शंस ऑफ only two variables. Okay, so if we have only two, we can very well name them as x and y. Okay, so we will look at this z, which is a function of x and y. So two independent variables. Okay, so let us investigate the following functional for the extremum. The functional, I will write it here, v z x comma y equal to capital F x y z, differentiating z with respect to x, differentiating z with respect to y, dx dy. So you can see here the functionals will look of this form, v z x comma y. Earlier we used to write it as v of y of x. Okay, so v was depending on the function y of x. Now in this case v will depend on the function z x comma y. Okay, and the functional capital F will be of this form. So the variable x, y and z, in fact this is, I don't write it that way, but actually it is z x comma y. Okay, and when I talk about derivative of this I cannot directly say d by dx of this, because it's depending on two independent variables and hence the partial derivative comes into the picture. Okay, so therefore the terms are dou z by dou x and dou z by dou y. Okay, so differentiating z partially with respect to x, differentiating z partially with respect to y. Okay, so capital F will be of this form and dy dx dy, because we are dealing with two independent variables. Okay, so we will examine the functional of this type for its extremum. Okay, now what do we mean by checking the extremum of such a functional? Okay, so the thing is, this z x comma y, the values of the function z x comma y are given on the boundary C of the domain D. Okay, so to see it in the picture form, if we have this domain D, okay, and this is called as the boundary C. Okay, so this is xy plane, and here we just imagine that this is lifted on top. Okay, my figure, it may not be so perfect, but okay, and then we are having a surface here. Okay, so this is the surface and this is its boundary. Okay, and this is surface z equal to z x comma y, and for this z x comma y the values are given on this boundary. Okay, so and all the permissible surfaces will pass through this boundary. Okay, what do I mean by permissible surfaces? Like how we had the admissible curves having the common boundary points. Okay, in a similar way here we will have the surfaces which are having the common boundary of the domain D. Okay, so if the if we look at all these surfaces z x comma y such that they have that common boundary, but the way they are varying here on top, like how okay? So this, however they are varying, we will have to find out that surface on which the functional will attain its extremum, okay? And the boundary conditions, if you relate it to the previous problem, like how we were given y at x naught is y naught, y at x1 is y1, okay? And we were looking at all the curves which satisfy the same boundary conditions, okay? So all the close lying curves. And then we used to find out the curve on which the functional will be extremized, okay? So here what we will do is we will look at all the surfaces, okay, such that they are having a, they are satisfying the condition which is prescribed on this boundary. That means they will start on this boundary, they will have this common boundary, but those surfaces will be different, okay? And then we want to find out that surface on which the given functional will attain its extremum, okay? So that is the problem, that is the, that is our aim in in this topic, okay? And you can clearly see here the functionals are having multiple integrals, and whatever we will be dealing with, we will have the, instead of differential equation, we will be having a partial differential equation, okay? So let us put this problem into in proper words. So it will be, consider a problem of finding extremum of the functional v z x comma y equal to double integral over the domain D capital F, which is depending on x, y, z, dou z by dou x, dou z by dou y, dx, dy, okay? This functional over region D by determining, so we are considering a problem of finding extremum of this functional. And how are we going to do that? That is by determining the curve, the surface, actually z equal to zx comma y, which is continuous and has continuous derivatives up to second order, and the values of the function zx comma y are given on the boundary C of the domain D. Okay, this is what I have told you all about the initial conditions. Okay, these values are already given on the boundary D of the on the boundary C of the domain D. Okay, and suppose that capital F is 3 times differentiable. Okay, so under all these conditions, what we want to do is we want to find out the find the extremum for this problem. Okay, and we will be deriving a necessary condition which should be satisfied by this surface zx comma y, like how in the previous examples we have derived the Euler-Lagrange differential equation, Euler-Poisson differential equation, okay? And the approach for this is the same as the Euler-Lagrange differential equation. So the idea is, what we will do is we will assume that the extremum is attained on one of the surface z equal to zx comma y, and then we will take one comparison surface which will be called as z tilde, okay? And then we will look at one parameter family of surfaces to determine on which surface the extremum is attained, okay? So before going for the proof, let us note down one lemma, because we will require this lemma when we want to conclude the proof, okay? So like how we have used the fundamental lemma of calculus, in that alpha of x, the function, the alpha was depending on only one function, that is on only one variable, that is x, okay? Now we will need something of this type, okay? So this lemma is for this quantity alpha x comma y. let alpha x comma y be a continuous function defined in a domain D which is a closed region. Let alpha x comma y h of x comma y dx dy this quantity be equal to 0. That is double integral over the domain D alpha x comma y h x comma y dx dy equal to 0 for every function h x comma y having continuous derivatives up to second order and is such that the function h x comma y vanishes on the boundary C. It vanishes on the boundary C of domain D. Okay, the function h x comma y, it vanishes on the boundary C of this domain D. Okay, so if this happens, then alpha x comma y is identically equal to 0 on this domain D. Okay, so if this double integral D alpha x comma y h x comma y dx dy is equal to 0 for all the functions h x comma y which are having these conditions, that is having the continuous derivatives up to second order and these functions are vanishing on the boundary, then this alpha x comma y is identically equal to 0 on the domain D. Okay, if you relate this to the fundamental lemma of calculus of variations, it's very very much similar to that. Okay, only in place of alpha of x we are dealing with the function of two variables, that is x and y. So now we start with this. Let z equal to z x comma y be the extremizing surface. That means this is a surface on which the functional attains its extremum. Okay, let z x y alpha be one parameter family of surfaces where z x y alpha is equal to this surface plus alpha times delta z x y. Okay, so z x y plus alpha times delta zxy, where what is this delta xzy, where this delta zxy is equal to z tilde xy minus z of xy. Okay, so you can see here we have taken one parameter family of surfaces which is of the form z x comma y equal to z x y alpha is equal to z x comma y plus some alpha times this, and you can observe this family is such that at alpha equal to 0 z x y 0 is equal to z x comma y, and at alpha equal to 1, z x y 1 is equal to, what will be that? At alpha equal to 1, it will be z x y minus this, so that is equal to z theta of x comma y. Okay, the admissible surface, this is the admissible surface. Like how we have considered y tilde of x, okay, that we had considered it as a comparison curve. Okay, so note that the extremal of the functional 1, okay, I'll write the functional 1 here again, z x comma y is equal to this domain capital F x y z dou z by dou x dou z by dou y dx dy. Okay, so notice that the extremal of this one is also included in this family, okay, because at alpha equal to 0 it becomes exactly equal to z x comma y. And what is z x comma y? It is a surface on which the functional is extremized. Okay, so in this family the extremal of this is also included. And it is also clear that when this z x y alpha is put here, okay, then we will be getting a function of one variable, that is alpha. Okay, so when we evaluate this v for all the curves belonging to, for all the surfaces of this family, that means z y comma alpha, okay, so when we look at this v z x y alpha, that will be a function of alpha, okay, one parameter alpha. And that will have an extremum for alpha equal to 0, because when I look at this, when I look at this v z x y alpha, okay, and when will this have the extremum? It will have extremum at alpha equal to 0, because at alpha equal to 0 this will get reduced to z x comma y, and on z x comma y it is having the extremum value. Okay, so what we say is the functional v, once we evaluate it for all the curves, all the surfaces of this family, okay, it gets reduces to a function of alpha, and then it will have the extremum for alpha equal to 0. Okay, and therefore this, differentiating it with respect to alpha at alpha equal to 0, is equal to 0. Okay, now if we relate this with whatever we have done in Euler-Lagrange differential equation, then you will observe that this quantity, it is called as delta of V. Okay, and what we will have is delta of V is equal to this, no? And how is this given? It will be given by differentiating with respect to alpha capital of F x y z, differentiating z with respect to x, differentiating z with respect to y dx dy, okay, evaluated at alpha equal to 0. Okay, now see here, if you relate it to the Euler-Lagrange equation, what will be this quantity? It will be nothing but delta of V. Okay, and this delta of V is given by this. Okay, so in this functional V z x comma y, we have evaluated it at z x y alpha. Okay, so that will be this functional. So let me write it because these two look very same, very much similar. Okay, you don't under it's not able, we are not able to identify the difference. Okay, the difference is lying here. See, this z, it's now depending on x, y and alpha, and when we have written it here, this z, it is depending on x, y, only x and y, and it's depending on x, y and alpha here. So let us write it more properly. So it will be differentiating with respect to alpha, this capital F, x, y, z, x, y, alpha, p. Okay, what we will do is, this differentiating z with respect to x, we will call this quantity as small p, and differentiating z with respect to y, we will call this quantity as, that means this, we will call it as q. Okay, so zx will be called as p and zy will be called as q. So I am writing this, so I have written it as p, which will also depend on x, y and alpha. Okay, and then there is q, which will depend on x, y and alpha, dx, dy, evaluated at alpha equal to 0. Okay, so this is what we have, and this is equal to, so now we want to differentiate this with respect to alpha. So what it will be, differentiating f with respect to x into differentiating x with respect to alpha, so that term will vanish, differentiating f with respect to y into differentiating y with respect to alpha, that term will also go, then differentiating f with respect to z, okay, and differentiating this z with respect to alpha. So we want to differentiate f with respect to z and differentiating this with respect to alpha. So what it will be, how this looks like, it looks like this. Okay, so we want to differentiate this quantity with respect to alpha, so that will be delta of this z. Okay, so this will be delta of z plus differentiating f with respect to p, okay, into differentiating this p with respect to alpha. So we want to differentiate this p with respect to alpha. I will not write this term for now because I just want to show you all how this family looks like. Okay, again, then what will be the next term, differentiating f with respect to q into differentiating this q with respect to alpha. Okay, and then this dx dy. Okay, so let us look at what is this, this p x y alpha. Okay, it is of the form p x y plus alpha into delta p. Okay, and what is this p, it is differentiating z with respect to x. What is that z? Z x y alpha. Okay, so in a similar way, differentiating z x y alpha with respect to y, we have named it as q x y alpha, and q x y alpha is q x y plus alpha times delta q. Okay, so now you can see here, what we wanted to do was differentiating f with respect to p into differentiating this with respect to alpha. But what is this? It is equal to this. So differentiating this with respect to alpha will give us delta p, and differentiating this with respect to alpha will give us delta q. Okay, so this p and q, they are just the notations to denote this zx and zy. Next, what we will do is, see here, in this expression, we will try to replace this term, okay, by using these two expressions, okay. So we want to replace this, okay, we are getting it here. So dou by dou x of this term, that is fp delta z, okay, is equal to this. What it is, differentiating this with respect to x into this as it is, plus keep this as it is into differentiating this with respect to x. Okay, now this is delta of z, and we want to differentiate delta of z with respect to x. Okay, so you can see here, what was delta of z? Delta of z was this. Okay, and we want to differentiate this with respect to x. So what will happen is, this will become zx, and this will become z tilde of x comma y, and minus z x of x comma y. So this will be px, and this will be p tilde of x. So that will be delta of p. Okay, so therefore what we get is, different, keeping this as it is, into derivative of this with respect to x is nothing but delta of p. Okay, similarly here, dou by dou y of this term, that is fq delta z, okay, that is equal to differentiating this with respect to y into this, that is here, and keeping this as it is, into derivative of this with respect to y, which will become delta of q. Okay, so now we got these two terms, and therefore in this expression we will replace these terms. Okay, so consider, what I will do is, first let us consider only this term, okay, along with this, consider this, then fp delta p plus fq delta q dx dy. So this we will get it as differentiating with respect to x fp delta of z plus differentiating with respect to y fq delta q this full thing dx dy minus, then it will be this. So differentiating with respect to x fp into delta of z plus, I have taken this minus sign common, okay, so then it will become this, differentiating with respect to y. Okay, so it is this minus this plus, here this term is this minus this, and then this is this minus this. Okay, so that minus term, those two terms I have taken it together, and this plus this, and here this delta z is common, no? So we'll write it outside the bracket here. So this will be delta of z dx dy. Okay, now also note that differentiating with respect to x this term, it is as good as differentiating, this is equal to this x plus differentiating it with respect to z into dz by dx plus differentiating with respect to p into differentiating it with respect to p with respect to x, and differentiating this with respect to q into differentiating q with respect to x. Okay, so this is just for your information. When we say that it is dou by dou x of fp, it's the total derivative of fp with respect to, well, not the total derivative, total partial derivative of fp with respect to एक्स. ओके एंड यू कैन सी हियर द वाई इज ट्रीटेड एज कॉन्स्टेंट इन दिस केस. ओके सो हाउ डू वी डिफरेंशिएट दिस पार्शियली एफ पी पार्शियली विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स. सो फर्स्ट डिफरेंशिएटेड विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स इन टू डेरिवेटिव डिफरेंशिएटिंग एक्स विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स दैट विल बी वन. ओके देन डिफरेंशिएटिंग टू विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू जेड एंड जेड इज ऑल्सो अ फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई. सो डिफरेंशिएटिंग जेड विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स. ओके एंड देन अगेन डिफरेंशिएटिंग इट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू पी एंड डिफरेंशिएटिंग अगेन दैट पी विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स डिफरेंशिएटिंग विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू क्यू इन टू डिफरेंशिएटिंग क्यू विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स. ओके सो एंड सिमिलरली इट विल हैपन ऑल्सो फॉर डो यू बाय डो वाई ऑफ एफ ऑफ क्यू बिकॉज वी एनकाउंटर दीज टू टर्म्स हियर नो. सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू दिस क्यू y. okay x will be treated as a constant term and it will be differentiating z with respect to y plus differentiating this with respect to p differentiating p with respect to this q differentiating q with respect to y. okay so next let us recall Green's theorem. We will recall this Green's theorem because we want to convert this double integral into single integral and then apply the boundary condition to it. Okay, so what does the Green's theorem says? The Green's theorem is differentiating n with respect to x plus differentiating m with respect to y dx dy. This is given by integral this over the domain D, then that is given by n into dy minus m dx. okay so when we apply this Green's theorem for this term then this term will be this differentiating with respect to x dou z plus differentiating with respect to y f q q. okay so this dx dy this term will be equal to f p plus f q then this will be this should be dou of delta of z. yes see here it should be delta of z minus this no so yes it should be delta of z. So this will be delta of z so it has to be yes so that is dy and dx delta of z. Okay, let me write it again. So over this it will be fp dy minus fq dx delta of z. Okay, now if you observe what will happen here is since the variation in the surface at the boundary. Okay, so on the boundary, when we are looking at the surface, the variation in the surface is equal to zero. And therefore, what will happen is this integral value will be equal to zero. Okay, because this delta of z is equal to zero here, and that is the reason how this goes to zero. Okay, and why this delta of z is zero? That is the variation is equal to zero because all the permissible surfaces pass through one curve that is the C. okay and therefore this variation on that c is equal to 0, and hence this full integral term, it goes to 0. So in turn, what is going to 0? That means this term is going to 0, that is, this term is going to 0, and hence what we will get is this double integral, this is equal to minus of this. Okay, therefore what we get is, from here, this term, it is equal to minus of this, because we have seen that this is going to 0. Okay, that is here, and which is equal to this, it's going to 0. So we substitute, therefore this is equal to this, that is fp into this delta p plus fq delta q dx dy is equal to minus this integral differentiating with respect to x fp plus differentiating with respect to y fq into delta of z dx dy. Now see here, we have started with this expression equal to this minus this. Then we showed that this is equal to 0, and therefore what we get is this expression is equal to minus of this. But whatever we had considered this, it was half the part of this expression. Here, yes, we have started with delta of v, and we have simplified that expression, and we got this expression. Okay, now in order to simplify this more, we considered only this term, and we tried to simplify this. Okay, and what we have got is this term, that is here, it is equal to minus of this. Okay, so now once we put this here, the necessary condition, for extremal, plus this fp into delta p plus fq into delta q, okay, this dx dy, the necessary condition for the extremal is this delta v equal to 0. Okay, and what is this delta v? We have simplified it, and we have got it as equal to this. So the necessary condition for the extremal is delta v, which is this, equal to 0. Okay, but what we have got, the simplified expression of this, minus of this. Okay, so therefore we get this double integral f of z minus, here also delta z is common, so differentiating with respect to x f of p plus minus differentiating with respect to y this f of q delta of z dx dy equal to 0. Now notice here, this delta of z is an arbitrary function which is continuous and differentiable, and delta of z is also equal to 0 on the boundary. Okay, and therefore by using this lemma, what we will conclude is this is working as good as alpha x comma y. Okay, and this is our hx comma y. It is satisfying all the properties of hx, y, and it's an arbitrary function, and also on the boundary this delta of z is equal to 0 because all the permissible curves are passing through the same contour C. Okay, here, and therefore that is equal to 0 on the boundary as well. And hence by using this lemma, what we conclude is this part is identically equal to 0. So therefore, by fundamental lemma, we get this minus x f p minus differentiating it with respect to y f q equal to 0. Okay. Thus the extremal z equal to z x comma y is attained which is a solution of the equation star. Okay, and equation star is called as, this is called as Ostrogradsky partial differential equation of, it's of second order. Okay, so whatever is that extrema, it will have to satisfy this Ostrogradsky equation. And you can clearly see here, this is not the differential equation, but it's a partial differential equation of second order. So therefore, this second order partial differential equation, which is called as the Ostrogradsky equation, must be satisfied by the extremizing function zx comma y. Okay, and this Ostrogradsky equation, it is named after the Russian mathematician whose name was M. Ostrogradsky.